So, good evening all of you. Today we'll study engineering geology. Under engineering geology, today we'll study site selection. Basically, we will study the overview of site selection of dams and tunnels. So, to start with site selection of tunnels. As we all know, nowadays tunnels is being prepared using tunnel hoeing machine. So the manual work done to prepare tunnel was is already being decreased to a larger extent by tunnel hoeing machine. So in tunnel construction, which is the tunnel construction which is simplified, accelerated and less costly by uniformity and soundness of rocks. So once you dig a tunnel will be the construction of tunnel will be simplified if you have an idea of the uniformity and soundness of the rocks. So if the rocks are uniform and as sound as well, then you can dig tunnel easily. Second, the greater the variation, the fracturization of layers, the more involved, expensive and time consuming the tunneling method will be. So if you have during your investigation, if you counter the variation and fracturization of the layers of the rocks or the soil, then you have to dig. We have to use a method which can be expensive one and time consuming too. So that's why the tunnel method will be prolonged for more period, and if it is for more period, then you have to spend more money. That's why it will be an expensive one. So the third one, mountain formations devoid of stratifications are much more favorable for tunneling. So once if you are doing tunneling under mountain formations or like devoid of stratifications, so these are much favorable conditions for tunneling than the composed mountains of several layers or shells. So if you have a mountain A which have a very less layers or the single layer of soil or rock, and here's a B mountain which has different layers composed in that or shells or gravel masses of varying degrees of stratification, then obviously you can do tunneling better in a A mountain than a B mountain. The adverse effects of stratification. What is what do you mean by stratification? Stratification is the formation of a soil layer throughout the gradual change of time and with the help of weathering. So this is the basic definition of stratification. So the adverse effects of stratification is shaling are the more pronounced, the more distinct and the thinner the individual layers are. So once the adverse effect of this stratification, as you know, stratification is a layer formation, and we have seen in mountain B, the more layers are there, the more problem will be there for tunneling. So the adverse effect of stratification will play there only. And the more stratification layers are pronounced or the more distinct they are, the layers which will be formed through stratification will be thinner. Where the tunnel axis is perpendicular to the strike of this steeply dipping rock stratum, the excavation of the tunnel is likely to succeed under favorable rock pressure conditions. The next is, however, where the tunnel axis is parallel to the strike, higher rock pressures may be expected to occur. So in this, where tunnel axis is perpendicular to this, the strike of the steeply dipping rock stratum, the excavation of tunnel is likely to succeed. So it is a favorable condition when you have the perpendicular strike, and where the tunnel axis is parallel to the strike, the rock pressures are high, and you may be expecting some difficulty from making the tunnel. So this is the example. When driving the tunnel perpendicular to the stratification, or we say perpendicular to the strikes, each individual stratum must act as a girder with a span equal to the width of the cross section and with a considerable depth. The only disadvantage of such stratification, this whole stratification, is the generally poor efficiency of blasting operations. So in this we may encounter a problem where in the efficiency of blasting operations only. But in this one, second one, when on the other hand the tunnel axis is parallel to the strikes in bedding place of the vertical strata, bridge action is limited to the extent until the shear strength is fully mobilized, while the inherent bending strength of the layer is not utilized unless an appropriate span is developed in the longitudinal axis of the tunnel. So this is how we can distinguish between two operations of the tunnel. Now, what about this? That was the overview of the tunnels, side section tunnel. What about that? We will study now the side section dams. In this one, topography for any dam construction, the impact on environment is nowadays given more importance. So wherever you will see nowadays, importance is given to environment in general, and wherever you make a dam, so special environment conditions, restrictions will be imposed while making a dam. Suitable foundation, the foundation should be located in strong impermeable rock. So we need strong foundations or suitable foundations which are strong and impermeable. Now, good site for reservoir. So what can be the, well, you have to make a dam, then you have to make reservoir too. And in that, the site, good site for reservoir will be which has a large capacity storage, which has shape of reservoir basin, water tightness of the reservoir must be ensured or must be good. Good hydrological conditions should prevail. The reservoir should be deep. Once you make a reservoir for dam, the reservoir should be deep. Small submerged areas shouldn't come when you make a dam and form a reservoir. Low silt inflow should be there, and no objectionable minerals. So there should not be any other minerals which will be which will come after the formation. You must know if there at all the minerals are there, then you must know beforehand that these minerals are there, and they are not hazardous to the structure then. Now, then availability of materials for construction. So you also have to see the availability of materials for construction, accessibility for transportation, the stay of the workers, healthy surroundings, and minimum overall cost. So now we have seen the two side sections, one of tunnel, one of dam. So this was our last topic under engineering geology, and here we have studied the whole syllabus of engineering geology, and right from the first lecture we have covered, up to this lecture we have covered all our 100% of our syllabus. So thank you.